Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our second FOTOvision. This event is sponsored, literally put on by the Downtown Development Association and Arts and Entertainment District, and representing them this evening is Tanika. We want to thank them so much. Get up, Tanika, so that everybody can say thank you. We want to thank the DDA and Arts District so much for doing this. This is amazing. We also want to thank Scott McKiernan, who he and Rory and his entire crew have put hundreds of hours putting this slideshow together for us. Thank you so much. So for those of you who are not familiar with the event, Palm Beach Photographic Center is a nonprofit organization dedicated to enriching life through the photographic arts. And we are the producers of FOTOfusion, which is an annual event this year on its 21st year. And you're going to see some amazing photographs. Some of these photographers will be at the center still tomorrow with lots of presentations, and many of them come back throughout the year to teach workshops. We teach photo workshops with some of the best photographers in the world. And you will see some of their photography here tonight. And then starting next Wednesday, every Wednesday evening, we have a lecture that's open to the community. It's at 7:30 p.m. in the library auditorium. This will be our 30th annual lecture, and it's going to be opened by one of my favorite photographers, Vincent Versace. So do join us Wednesday evening. And now I would like to introduce Scott. And Scott is founder and CEO of Zuma Press. And he is also the publisher of Double Track, an amazing photo magazine, and producer of the Walter Iooss exhibition in the museum of this show, and many other accolades that he wants me to stop talking. So, please help me welcome Scott McKiernan.
Dueling microphones, okay. All right, good evening. Thanks for coming. It's very strange, but there's no one in the first row. But it's a reverse of where I live in California, where everybody fights to be in the first row. But thanks for coming. I'm glad, even though we were worried about the rain, we were going to do it outdoors like we did last year. But this is a pretty cool space. So I'd like to again thank Tanika and Raphael and whomever else makes all this magic happen. You guys rock. And this city is pretty amazing. I don't know where most of you all are from, but I know a lot of you are not from here. I doubt your city can roll out a carpet for the arts the way this town does. So I'd like to give applause to the city and to Tanika. And also the Tyrell and what's her name? What was our surfer girl's name who left before? There are many other people who help make these things possible that you never see, or they're behind the scenes, and they're just as important. So without further ado, FOTOvision is a fairly simple concept. We're going to go and see about 60 minutes of some of the best photography from all over the world. And it's really easy in some ways because we have 55 presenters at this year's FOTOfusion. The center has many other presenters during the year as well, so there might be as many as 100 amazing people in the arts and photography and the craft of making great photography attending, coming through here over the next 12 months. The Palm Beach Photographic Center, as you may or may not know, is a nonprofit, so take classes, be a member, help support it, tell your friends, and then tell their friends. I don't know. And it's also important to know all this is never possible without the presenters who come to FOTOfusion. Every one of them volunteers their time, so they're totally doing this out of the good graces of their heart and their desire to pass on the craft. And I always felt very lucky in this field. I've done well, but many people mentored me. Among them, Arnold Dramkin, who was the person who told me about this when it was getting founded. And without him, I definitely wouldn't be involved in many things, and I wouldn't have been half the photographer I think I became. I don't know. That's totally you guys decide that. And then another person who was very big in my career was Jimmy Colton, who's also very involved with the center. Hey, Jimmy, stand up. I get to embarrass somebody else. Woo! Jimmy's an amazing editor, an inspiring person, won the top award you can win in our business for mentoring this year. MPPA gives it out. They'll be giving it out next month. And, you know, he's a true testament to the industry, and we're very lucky to have him. And this center, he's come to every PhotoFusion. So Walter Iooss, Jr., has been to every Super Bowl. Only 11 people have been to every Super Bowl, and only 3 of them are photographers, 3 of them are writers. So how many people have been to every PhotoFusion besides Jimmy? I know there are a couple of you. Would you stand up? And then I'll stop doing this part and we'll get to the pictures. So, Jimmy Shallow, Rob Straub, woo! Any instructors been to everyone? Professor Lopez. Anybody else? Is there anybody who's not here right now, who's shunning us right now, but always comes here? And Arnold? Okay. So that's 6 people. Obviously, Fachma and Art. And so that's 8. Okay. Cool. I've only been to 20, and I think they're 21, right? So slacker. But, you know, trying. Even dwarfs started small. Don't forget that. So the format's pretty simple. Some of the work, I made the last piece that I show. I made it from its normal R-rated version to PG. But news doesn't pull punches. Reality is not always pretty. It's not always sugar-coated. So one thing I'd like to open with, I'm going to introduce, each one of the photographers here will introduce the person who's coming on after them. For the people who are not here, I will introduce them. There is also, by the way, as well as popcorn outside, there is beer and wine. I don't want you guys to leave, but feel free to get some beer. I would if I could. So last year, for anybody who was here last year, Louis Palau was here, amazing guy, won every award in the book. I'm very proud to have him as a dear friend and represent him at Zuma. And he showed all this work he had done in Kandahar, in Afghanistan. And at the time, he was searching for funding to do a movie about it. So he's done the movie. And this was actually a very good step in that process. It helped him organize his thoughts on it and didn't make it happen, but really was an important step in the process. So I'm going to show you a trailer, because I can't show you the movie, because he's going to be in a festival down here in Florida very shortly. And you are precluded from a festival if it's shown as an itinerary before that. Should you happen to be in New Jersey, I believe it's in New Jersey, Jimmy, right? For when Jimmy gets his mentor award, Louis will show his movie then. And I'm sure you're all going to be there at the Radisson, February, whatever. But it'll show around. It's called Kandahar Journal. And it is, we got him a long-term assignment from Newsweek. There's a news magazine that used to be pretty prolific. And he went many times. He went and covered the Canadian soldiers that were battling in the war. We have here, Vincent Versace is our barmaid for the night. Woo! I am proud to be on the board. I'm not so sure about it today because I'm exhausted, but Vincent's also on the board, and he may not be sure about it either some days. But what kind of beer we got? We got Blue Moon?
Blue Moon.
Blue Moon. Do you guys tip the barmaid at all? Oh, Blue Moon. Awesome. Yeah, I know. No. No worries. You're not having a beer? Okay. My job is to drink for you guys. Cheers. And thank you to you guys. Without you guys, it doesn't happen. Sean, I toast you from afar. Alrighty. Whoa, God damn it.
He's cut off, totally.
Okay, sorry about that. Sorry, Kevin. We're starting out really well. That looked flat. Alrighty. So without further ado, I'm gonna play a trailer from the movie that Louis is gonna do. It is a little bit intense. It is probably the most intense thing I'm going to show you, if not psychologically. But I think it's important it's real. He went and covered what was going on in Afghanistan. I think it's ended up as the longest war in our history, though I could be wrong, but it's definitely way too long. And he, a lot of the movie is a series of the stills he did put together to make a movie. So he actually didn't shoot film, but he shot pieces of the moments and they put it all together. And it's really powerful. So I recommend seeing Ken Hart Journal, and if it's at a festival, vote for it. And it will be in theaters, not too many of them, but it'll be in art theaters and stuff starting in about 2 months. So without further ado, Kandahar Journal by Louis Palau.
So I have some pretty phenomenal memories of working in Kandahar, especially Kandahar City.
Right behind you.
I think what really struck me was not just what I was seeing, but the smell. The smell burned itself into my mind.
September 23rd, 2010. I have almost made it. It will take so much time to move on. The experience is beyond the photos.
Thanks. Walter, before I introduce Walter, Louis has a Facebook page, Kandahar Journal's Facebook, and you can see if the movie is playing where you are. Many people who were in the movie, different helicopter pilots, the Canadians, the helicopters that evac and medic, all the Canadians and all the other soldiers that are not American are actually almost all American pilots. So there's actually a unit that's down in Miami area that is going to come to the Florida Festival with family and members and stuff. It's quite a tight group, and they're extremely proud that their true story is being represented and being played forward. And I was a war photographer, so I guess it's closer to my heart than most people's. I did 12 conflicts, and the movies you usually see are slightly disrespectful to what really happens and to the players involved in it quite often. Not all of them, but most of them. So I recommend if you want to see and understand better, great journalist at work, I go see the movie. So next, without further ado, Walter Iooss Jr. If anyone knows how to pronounce Walter's last name properly 100%, please stand forward. Adam, do you know how to pronounce Walter's name right? Iooss. Okay, so it's like a Y in the front. That was the number one question I got asked. They all knew who he was as a photographer when I got him to come to the center to have the great show he's had. But every report, everybody asked, how do you pronounce that guy's name? And so I said, I thought it's like with a Y, but I may be wrong. Walter, did everybody see the show in the museum? So you know a little bit about him, know nothing, maybe in between. Walter is by far the best sports photographer ever. And that's not something I would say lightly. If Neil and some other people were around, they could argue with me. So there are a lot of great photographers who cover sports. But what makes Walter unique is when you see an action photo of his, I personally feel like I was there. And even if I was there covering that Olympic or that World Series or that story, he saw it even from a different perspective, and I could be standing only 5 feet away from him. And his ability at action is bar none to me. And the other thing that's amazing about him, and the reason I called the show and the piece you're going to see now, Triple Play, is because he could also make portraits with the best, and then everybody's seen his swimsuit photos. And that's not a bad thing. It's a great group of photos. And he always tried to take it further. He did 35 years of the swimsuit. He's the last one 2 years ago. He's done 50. He'll be doing 50 Super Bowls as of 2 weeks from now. And he started at the ripe old age of 15, first assignment at SI, and still working. He's off to go do a shoot in 2 weeks at the Super Bowl and something in between. He has an advertising shoot. So he's a phenomenal man, and he very rarely, he's not big on shows, and he's not big on speaking, so we were very lucky the other day. He sat down with Jimmy Colton and myself, and he poured it out from his heart. It wasn't really an interview. It was more a beautiful Walter Live diary. So hopefully you like the work, and this is Walter Iooss, Jr., Triple Play.
A big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shouts and kicks in my.
Thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses.